The long-awaited undisputed matchup of Canelo Alvarez versus Caleb Plant was finally confirmed by Canelo himself on Thursday afternoon. Posting to his various social channels, Canelo said, "This November 6th will put Mexican boxing on top. Let's go for the missing belts." Caleb Plant's IBF super middleweight title is the last piece needed for Canelo to become the first Mexican undisputed super middleweight champion. And as Eddie Hearn stated himself, time to make history on his social media. All right, Barack, after months of going back and forth, you know, we know after the Saunders fight, this is what Canelo wanted, and we were there. And then, boom, the fight fell apart. We start talking about Bivol and other possible fights for Canelo Alvarez. At any point did you think, nah, I think this fight is still going to happen. I don't see him fighting anybody else. Or did that ship sail for you as well, Barack?
No, I have to be truthful. I'm not somebody who looks for the gossip. I don't ask anybody for any scoops. So I only hear what everybody else hears. And I thought it was over. I thought he was going to move on. I really see that Eddie Hearn was pushing towards Bivol. I wanted to see Beterbiev. But of course, this is the only fight I wanted to see, but I didn't think it was going to happen, truthfully. You know, I thought there was going to be too many things. You know, I know the guy Canelo wants to fight. This is going to make four times in 1 year. He actually wanted to fight five times. You know, he wanted this in September and then another fight before December, so he would have fought five times. So I know he wanted to fight, and I know he wanted Caleb, but I just didn't think it was going to happen, so I'm very surprised about this.
Listen, you just mentioned, Barack, how many times he's fought. I mean, think about it. As far as you can go back, let's be honest here. Has there ever been an elite fighter at his level to fight that many times for that many chances? And I'm not talking about Sugar Ray Robinson days. I'm talking about the era in the last 30 years. You know, this once was a three-belt era, now it's a four-belt era. Has anybody been that consistent, that level of fighting?
No. Maybe Holyfield, maybe when he was light heavyweight. But see, this is the thing, man. It's all about who fighters look up to and who's leading the pack. And Floyd Mayweather was leading the pack, and because he was doing pay-per-views, he felt like it took 3 months to even promote a pay-per-view properly, because he said that one time on All Access. No, it was actually on HBO. And because of that, him fighting two times a year, everybody's kind of taking that. And then some fighters even fight once a year because, you know, it's expensive for them to fight. And, you know, they get paid so much you can't even, you know, afford more than that. You know, so I think because of Floyd, possibly, that's acceptable now. Nobody looks at that and says, oh, you're not fighting enough.
No, a lot of things are acceptable now because of what Floyd did. Not only fighting twice a year, but not taking risks, that many risks in the ring in terms of engagement in the later part of his career. Now, this is not shots at Floyd. Floyd did exactly what he needed to do as his career progressed, as his age progressed. He did not fight that way when he was young. But I noticed that a lot of these young fighters are fighting more so like that, even in terms of picking opponents. Yeah, maybe Floyd, I wouldn't say cherry pick, maybe pick strategically when he was in his late 30s.
I don't even agree. Cotto fought at his weight, at a proper weight, no catch weight. Floyd beat everybody.
What I'm saying, Floyd is great, right? Arguably the best fighter ever. What I'm saying is, what he did late in his career, fighters in their 20s are trying to do that. But we're off topic here. Look, the truth is that
I don't mind a good argument right now. Yeah, you're talking about Floyd. You're getting on my nerves.
I don't see, as far as I can remember, any fighter to be this busy at this level in his career. Remember, these are unification bouts. I mean, you're talking about Callum Smith. That was a world title fight. And you keep people bringing up Yeldrick. Then you're talking about Billy Joe Saunders, another world title fight. And then now in November, fighting the guy that a lot of people feel like he's the guy that's going to outbox Canelo Alvarez. They said the same thing about Saunders.
Exactly. And you said you were one of those people that said Billy Joe is a better fighter than Caleb, and this was going to be tough for him, and it wasn't tough at all. And not just to mention that, he also fought Callum Smith 10 weeks later, the same amount of time that he gave Kovalev to prepare. 10 weeks, and he fought a better fighter as well, too. But 10 weeks later, he fights Yildirim. 10 weeks later, again, he fights another champion, undefeated, Billy Joe Saunders. That's record breaking, if you ask me, and in this generation.
Look, I mean, beyond record breaking, let's move forward. Let's go to November 7th, Barack. Canelo wins big.
Six.
Let's go
seventh.
To November
7th. You mean the day
7th.
After?
Oh, yes, okay. Let's go to November 7th. All no right? Doubt. Afterwards, if Canelo destroys a Caleb Plant. What
Why
would
you have
be
to say
a...
destroy? No, Why no, not no. just beat him? Caleb is a great fighter.
He's a hell of a fighter, and I don't think Canelo destroys him. I'm saying, let's say he does. What will the people say then? Well, they say Caleb Plant never really fought anybody to win that title. You know how these fight fans are. Will they want to see him go up back to light heavyweight and fight those other guys? Who knows? I'm thinking ahead because I already know what's going to come out of people's mouths, what's going to come out of their phones, on social media. It's going to be crazy, man. I'm super amped about this. I can't wait to be in Vegas for this one, B.
Well, there's never a shortage of haters. And I think the haters should be a little bit considerate and smart enough to say, to let a man at least enjoy his victory. And that's something they don't even do. You know, even me, if I tend to not like anyone. But I would, if I didn't like a fighter's style, let's say, I'd give him that victory. Good victory. Give him some time. And then say, well, now let's fight this guy over here. You know, but if Canelo does this and he becomes the first Mexican undisputed four belt era super middleweight champion, then this is an amazing legacy. Like we always say, he's right behind Pacquiao. Pacquiao has the best resume in boxing right currently, and Canelo's right behind. 16 champions beaten.
I don't know, Barack. It seems like Canelo Alvarez pulled up Floyd Mayweather on Manny Pacquiao. What's going on?
Absolutely, man. I'm just going to steal your shine. And I don't even have a fight this weekend. I'm just going to announce a fight months from now. That's definitely Floyd, but I think it's with a different heart. It wasn't like what Floyd was doing to disrupt things.